They said that the old city of Jerusalem was a holy city. But it wasn't quite so holy. They killed and persecuted the prophets there. They exploited them. They oppressed the poor there. But in God's emerging new way, there will be a new Jerusalem. For the old Jerusalem did not qualify to be the capital of God's new world. I saw a new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, adorned as a bride to meet her husband. Then he talked about a God-centered society in the center of God's new world. There he would be among his people, and they would know him. They would recognize him. That is to say, they would know holiness or wholeness. They would know goodness. They would know justice. They would know love. They would know peace. Walls would be abandoned. The poor would be accepted and recognized and given their fair share of whatever the social order yields. I don't believe you praying today. He heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. He will dwell among them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God." And then another very significant thing he said, he would wipe all tears away. You know, as we study the circumstances of our society, men and women, boys and girls, have all kind of reason to shed tears. I recall one of our late great leaders, Dr. Underwood, who talked about tears on one occasion, saying he did not know where tears came from, that he could locate the fountain of blood, and he could locate all other things about the body, but he couldn't locate tears. He only knew that when a man got or a woman got a certain attitude, and when they felt sorry from some mysterious place, tears would come. Or I could think of a thousand reasons that men have a right to cry, that women have a right to cry. Mothers and fathers have a right to weep over the disappointment that is brought into their lives by their children. You don't hear me? They built all kinds of hopes, and they made all kinds of plans, and they dreamed of the children doing better than they did, and enjoy things that they never enjoyed in their own childhood. Oh Lord. And then that girl or that boy rise up to bring sorrow to their hearts, disappointment and frustration to their dreams. Oh We have to cry.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Oh, Lord. Thy women have to cry sometimes, as well as men.
Yeah.
They dream of blissful marriages. And they dream of ideal husbands. And they dream of ideal wives. And not only is there no love involved, not even right thinking and right dealing with one another. Sometimes we have to cry. You don't hear me now. Oh, Lord. And then we run into all kinds of misfortune, all kinds of bad luck, of disappointment that make us have to wring our hands and cry. Oh, Lord. But John said, and I'm nearly through, that in God's new world there'd be no more tears. Oh, Lord. And then no more sorrow. But then there's another thing, no more sickness. Every time I see the hospital as I pass, every time I behold a clinic, every time I see the doctor in Cigna, shelves crowded with medical antidotes, it make me know that we live in a world of sickness. Not only mentally, and not only physically, but also mentally. Oh, Lord. But in God, the door is open. trust in themselves. Some put all of that trust in their bank accounts. Some trust the government. And some trust their armed forces. But I found out all of these things will ultimately fail. So I will trust in meet again, but I want you to tell the world that I told you tonight.